How are you guys doing? Today is Sunday, July 18th, 2021. I'm James Sims, and for this episode of The Elite, I'm going to do an individual profile on A. Eugenio Suarez. The elite infielder for the Cincinnati Reds turns 30 today, and my objective with this episode is to, of course, paint a full picture of his career from the moment he stepped into the spotlight into now, to give viewers and baseball fans and prospective baseball fans at least a glimpse into his accolades, the achievements, and what he's been able to accomplish while he's been a player in the MLB. If you're unfamiliar with Eugenio Suarez, I guess he's defensively is a really good player, but of course he's more known for his power. He's a player that only has one All-Star, but if you look over his career, he's sneakily been able to build himself up into one of the best hitters in baseball, despite only being named to one All-Star game. So just going through, starting from the beginning, he's originally from Venezuela. He would sign with the Detroit Tigers as an amateur free agent in 2008 when he was a teenager. He would eventually get called up to play for the Detroit Tigers after spending his entire minor league career in their farm system. He would finally come up in 2014 in his age 22 season. In that year, he would play 85 games in a season where the Detroit Tigers would go on to finish with a 90-72 record. I was actually the last time that the Tigers made the playoffs, in other words, like at the same time. But in that season, in the 85 games he played, he finished with 59 hits with a .242 batting average on the year, with a .652 OPS. He also finished with 4 home runs and 23 RBIs as he was still really establishing a role for himself. But following that season, he would eventually get traded to the Cincinnati Reds, and the Cincinnati Reds are where he's been ever since. His first year in Cincinnati would be in 2015, in his age 23 season. In 2015, he would play 97 games in a season where the Reds finished with a 64-98 record. Of course, completely missed the playoffs, so they finished last in their own division. In that season, in the 95 games he played, Suarez finished with 104 hits, the first time he had more hits than games played, 42 runs, which was an improvement from the previous year. He had 13 home runs alongside 48 RBIs. He would also finish with a .280 batting average and a .761 OPS, which were ticks higher than the previous year. And then, so by the end of 2015, he had established himself as a solid starter for the Cincinnati Reds. In 2016, in his third year in the league and his second year in Cincinnati, he would be a full-time starter. In his age 24 season, Eugenio Suarez would play 159 games in a season where the Reds finished with a 68-94 record. They won 4 more games in the previous season, but they were still completely out of the playoff race. In his very first full season as a starter, Suarez would finish with 140 hits in 159 games. He finished with a career-high 78 runs at the time. He would finish with 25 doubles the first time he eclipsed 20. He also eclipsed 20 home runs for the first time, as well as he finished with 21 home runs and 70 RBIs. His batting average would dip from .280 to .248, and his OPS would dip from .761 to .728. But by then, he was a full-time starter for the Cincinnati Reds, considering, you know, a couple years ago, the Detroit Tigers didn't even want him. So going into his third season in Cincinnati and his fourth season in the league in 2017, Eugenio Suarez would play 156 games in 2017 for Cincinnati Red team that finished with a 68-94 record for the second year in a row. This particular year, in the 156 games he played, he finished with 139 hits, less hits than games played. He would finish with 87 runs, which by then, or even now, is tied for his career high. He finished with 25 doubles, which tied with the previous year for the most he's ever put up in a season. He would finish with 26 home runs and 82 RBIs. Both would be career highs at that point. He would finish with a .260 batting average and an .828 OPS as he was slowly building himself into a player that many people would start to recognize as an all-star. In his fifth year in the league in 2018, in his age 26 season, Eugenio Suarez would make the All-Star game for the only time in his career as he played 143 games in a season where the Reds finished with a 67-95 record. They won one less game than the year before, But Eugenio Suarez would hit that next level. He finished with 149 hits in 143 games, which is the second time, at least in his first 5 years, that he finished with more hits than games played, not to mention he had 79 runs on the year. He would finish with 22 doubles, which would be the third season he had 20 doubles in a row, or third season in a row in which he had at least 20 doubles. He finished with 34 home runs and 104 RBIs. 34 home runs by then was the first time he eclipsed 30, so that was a career high. And 104 RBIs is the most RBIs that Suarez has ever put up in a season. He would finish the year with a .283 batting average, which is also the highest batting average he'd ever finished with. He finished with an .892 OPS. And like I said, he was named an all-star despite the Cincinnati Reds finishing with the worst record in their own division. Following his lone all-star season, he would come back to Cincinnati for his fifth season there in 2019. And in his age 27 season, the last full 162-game season he played in the league, or at least up until now, he played 159 games in a season where the Reds would finish with a 75-85 record. They finished with the fourth best record in the NL Central, still missing the playoffs completely. And Eugenio Suarez would finish with 156 hits in 159 games. That is the most hits he's ever put up in a season to date. He finished with 87 runs, which ties him with 2017 for the most runs he ever put up in a year. He finished with 22 doubles, which ended his four-year streak of at least 20 doubles in a year. He would finish with 49 home runs. He didn't make the All-Star team this year. And 103 RBIs. He would eclipse his career high in home runs by 15, but he would have one less RBI than his career high. He would finish leading the National League in strikeouts as he struck out 189 times in 159 games. He would go on to finish with a .271 batting average and a .930 OPS. This would be the highest OPS he's ever had in his career. And like I said, following that, the Cincinnati Reds would not make the playoffs. And then this would lead them into the 2020 season, which many baseball fans are aware was heavily affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, that the 162-game season got shortened to 60 games. And as a result, they had to expand the playoffs that year. So in Eugenio Suarez's age 28 season in 2020, he would play 50 of Cincinnati's 60 games in a season where they would actually make the playoffs. They finished with the third best record in the NL Central as they made the playoffs for the first time since 2013. In the shortened season, Suarez would finish with 40 hits in the 57 games that he played with 29 runs. Finished with 15 home runs along 38 RBIs. He had a .202 batting average and a .781 OPS, as of course he didn't have the full season that he expected to have. But he was actually able to make it to the playoffs for the first time, so I don't think he minded. But the Reds would end up losing in the first round to the Braves. This is the year where Trevor Bauer won the National League Cy Young, which was last year. And following that shortened season, he will come back to where he is right now in 2021. He is currently in his age 29 season, where he is now turning 30. He's played 30 games so far for a Cincinnati Reds team that is the first on the outside of the National League wild card. Probably the best win percentage that they've had since they look like they might finish with the best win percentage that they've had since Suarez has been there. So thus far this season, he has 57 hits through 90 games. As he has a .170 batting average and a .614 OPS. 44 runs, though, in those 90 games, so he is scoring. Not to mention he has 18 home runs and 52 RBIs a little over halfway through the season. So he is on pace to put up some pretty good numbers. It's just that his averages aren't necessarily there. But at the end of the day, he's still the same player. Just looking at his progression to a player that could be relied on to hit with such volume. I mean, the fact that he only made one All-Star game, I think he probably should have made more. But I think that for this 2021 calendar year, I think his argument is not like many. I do think that if you get a chance to watch Eugenio Suarez, you get a chance to understand just why many baseball fans, especially in Cincinnati, hold him in such high regard. Not this season, but I think one season shouldn't distract you from the entire body of work. And if you ever get a chance to watch him, I would. I want to thank ESPN, the MLB.com websites, and Baseball Reference for, of course, giving me the stats and figures to do this episode. I want to thank everyone for listening to all 9.5 minutes of this piece. If you ever get a chance to watch Eugenio Suarez, he wears number 7 for the Cincinnati Reds. And of course, I want to take this time to wish Eugenio Suarez a happy 30th birthday. The man is entering his 30s with only one All-Star. It is very possible with the way that he plays that he could just be so much better in his 30s. By this time next year, we'll hopefully see whether he can, we'll see what he does in this next 365 days. But of course, with this time, I want to thank everyone once again for listening to my piece. I hope all is well. Correction, 366 days, because I'm forgetting the leap year. But last but not least, I want to thank everyone once again for listening to this piece. I hope all is well. And hopefully by this time next year, I'll have more to talk about. So until then, peace out. I'll catch you next year.